Let me present Frank Demondi.
Hello there. Good time. Nice to see you.
Nice.
One of the attendants may be a little bit.
All right. Well, it's nice to meet my daughter, Jiro. My daughter, Maureen. That you were a stalwart in making, letting her become.
Jane Demondi.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Did you?
I got.
Oh, you did.
Thank you.
All right.
Mr. President, Bill Demondi, Frank's son. How are you, sir?
Just fine.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. President, Frank Demondi, Jr.
Well,
nice to meet you.
See you.
Thank you.
Mr. President, Basil Battaglia.
Yes.
Nice seeing you, sir.
How are you?
Thanks for having us.
Well, pleased to have you all here.
Now we can get the family photo, I think, with everybody together.
Grouping right there.
Yeah.
Good.
Okay. One more. That'll do it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, my daughter Maureen has spoken about how influential he was and her winding up as second in command of the Republican National Committee.
Yes.
One of his attempts at all these years as Republican and Republican chairman of Delaware has been to change the party's symbol to the buffalo. From the elephant, at least for one day, if not for a little bit longer than that. And we met with a lot of problems with Governor DuPont while he was governor. He rebuked us several times at every convention, mind you. But we're going to try one more time this coming weekend.
Well, you know, it's very funny that where the two symbols did come from. It was a cartoonist named Nast in a paper in New York that did a ridiculous false story about the animals escaping in Central Park and so forth. And he did a cartoon, and he had the donkeys running here and so forth, and the elephant all there. And the next thing you know, it just got picked up by the cartoonist, and that they became the symbols. Well, listen, you have to hear what souvenirs here. Your visit to the Oval Office, a key ring, the seal on it.
Thank you. Okay.
No problem.
I was glad to see you do wear tie bars.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Well, no,
very, very nice.
You bet.
But whether it's buffalo or whether it's elephant, I'm glad you're the state chairman there, because we're going to have to keep those two animals, as long as they're
that's
the
right
symbols they are
here.
Washington.
Well, our national chairman is going to visit us in Rehoboth Beach, Delaware, next weekend for our state convention, and he'll be our keynote speaker.
That's great.
And we're looking forward to it. Well, thank you for having us.
Well,
it's very, very nice, sir.
Nice meeting you, sir.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Well, pleased to see you.
Thank you very much.
Mr. President, Ken, thank you.
My pleasure.
Yeah. I'm going to start wearing tie bars. Thank you. Bye now.
Mr. President Davis.
How do you do? How are you?
Nice to see you.
Yes.
Mr. President, Eric Schar, I'm the president of the University of the University.
It's good to have you.
Thank you very much.
Mr. President, Jack Rommel, board chairman.
Good to see you.
Mr. President, hockey coach Frank Ansel.
Hello there.
Nice to meet you.
Hello, it's nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Jim Long,
nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Hello, hi, Jeff.
Chairs.
All right. Will, congratulations to you all. And you had to knock off a few pretty big schools. I had to come to small school myself. Played my buddies there. We were having a little cross-the-border socializing here with the Prime Minister of Canada, Prime Minister Mulroney. Incidentally, while they're getting in, you can be getting them in if you want to. Weren't you going to?
Oh, yes. I just wanted to make sure we were lined up on that.
Okay. Yeah. If everybody could turn slightly sideways and squish in closer.
Rodney said no. I once suggested that to the president of Notre Dame, and he told me that Notre Dame would never endorse a game and put a club in the hands of an Irishman.
Mr. President, would you like to start off by giving you this hockey stick to keep as a memory of Lake Superior State, our hockey team? And we'd also like you to, if you wouldn't mind, signing this stick, which we'd like to bring back to our school and put in our trophy case. Your pen or mine, it doesn't matter, and we thought that spot would
be there. All right. Well, do you want to keep more blue, or you got a good, my pen's black?
All right, we'll use, yeah, let's use the black one. Share the present, it'll stick out good.
Mr. President, you can't use your hockey stick without a
hockey shirt.
President, we got to bring some photographers back in if you can hold that picture.
Citizens of Sault Ste. Marie, I'd like to give you this as a token of their esteem for you as our President Commander-in-Chief. He too is sitting here.
For heaven's sake.
The university and the community are very close together. Sault Ste. Marie, Michigan.
Yeah.
Well, we're proud to be from there and just proud of us.
Well, thank you very much. For the key that big, I ought to be able to laugh the conversation. Thank you all. And congratulations again.
Thank you very much.
It's something we're really proud of.
Well, it's a great thrill for these young men. It was just a great long season, and they worked very hard for this honor. And you've just capped off a tremendous thing for these boys. And we want to thank you, Canadian, American, and all, for this, for your moment in time. Thank you very much.
Well, I appreciate having you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. President.
Thank you.
Thank you again, Mr. President.
You explain that is to me.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Judy Black from your staff. It's with pleasure I present some individuals from Maine today.
Governor Kernan. Thank you for doing this again with us.
Well, Governor, pleased to do it.
I appreciate it. I mean, Congressman Brando.
Thanks very much for continuing this great tradition. Thank you very much.
Pleased to.
Nice to see you, President. Thank you for having us again. We appreciate it. Thank you.
This is Charlie Karen, who is the one who's presenting the salmon that he caught. That's exactly right.
How big was the one that got away?
That's a beauty.
This is the first fresh one at a salmon this year in the United States and Canada. So it's really a pleasure and privilege to give it to us.
Listen, I think this is quite a tradition. I like it very much. It's just great.
What do you weigh?
8.5 pounds. How are we doing? Do we need to turn it or?
We take it off the trailer?
No, I think we just need to
small.
We're going to turn sideways. Why don't we turn it
sideways?
There we go.
Won't slide.
Until that just
make sure it doesn't.
Let's get a little groove in it.
Oh.
No, it is. That's it.
I hope you like it.
I love it.
I was produced the same reaction.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. President.
And Al Meister as well.
Mr. President, it's a pleasure.
Well,
good luck to you in Moscow.
Well, thank you very much. Why don't we all get a group picture?
I do one.
I have one little problem here. I understand that behind every successful man is a very intelligent young lady. One of the ladies in the state of Maine that ties these flies has presented this approach to you or she to Mrs. Ray.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Oh, all right, Charlie. Right in here.
It's
important.
Right
there.
Right
in front. There we go. That's great.
There we go. Yeah, get in a little closer. Can you turn, move in closer? Yeah. Yeah, we should have. Hold him up a little higher. That's good. Oops. Okay, great. Thank you
very much. What I'm to you, I get the fish and I didn't have to get a bird. Was very tactful.
Okay, number four is national.
Mrs. Gladys Harrington?
Well, Mrs. Harrington, hello there. How are you?
How nice to know you. Okay.
Dr. Jerry Nems?
Hello, Joy, sir. Good to see you. We speak with on the Restoration Act. We're going to be with you.
Mrs. Lynette Bright?
Hello, sir.
Nice to see you.
Mr. Pat Boone?
Well,
you dude it. You dude it. Thank you.
This is Susan Sarensen.
Hello there. Nice to see
good
you.
Good to meet you.
Rabbi Joshua Haberman?
How do you do?
God bless you, Mr.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
Father O'Connor?
Mr. President, it's a pleasure. God bless you.
Congressman Tony Hall?
Hi, Mr. President. How are
you? Good.
Congressman Carlos Moorhead?
Hi, Mr. President. How are you? Good to see you.
And Congressman Frank Wall.
Thank you.
See you. When I sign that, that means that from now on, it's going to be, and thanks to these members of the Congress who are here and had a hand in this, that permanently will be the first Thursday in May will be a National Prayer Day.
It'll be much easier to plan for it, too, because they'll know what day it's going to be.
Well, and, you know, Lincoln said that he couldn't stand the duties of this office for one day if he did not know that he could call on one who was wiser and stronger than all others.
Yeah. Right.
But I thought you might be interested in something here. Just I received this from a war widow. And this was evidently a prayer from a young soldier in World War II out in a shell hole in the middle of the night. Hear me, O God. Never in the whole of my lifetime have I spoken to you. But just now I feel like sending you my greetings. You know, from childhood on, they've always told me you are not. I, like a fool, believed them. I've never contemplated your creation, and yet tonight, gazing up out of my shell hole, I marveled at the shimmering stars above me and suddenly knew the cruelty of the lie. I've never contemplated your creation, and yet tonight, gazing... Oh, I started to read that. I've read that. Will you, my God, reach your hand out to me, I wonder? But I will tell you, and you will understand. Is it not strange that light should come upon me and I see you amid this night of hell? And there's nothing else I have to say. This, though, I'm glad that I've learned to know you. At midnight, we're scheduled to attack, but you are looking on and I am not afraid. The signal, well, I guess I must be going. I've been happy with you. This more I want to say. As you well know, the fighting will be cruel and even tonight I may come knocking at your door. Although I've not been a friend to you before, still, will you let me enter now, when I do come? Well, I'm crying, O God, my Lord. You see what happens to me. Tonight my eyes were opened. Farewell, my God. I'm going, and I'm not likely to come back. Strange, is it not? But death I fear no longer. And this was found on the body of a young Russian soldier, killed in action in 1944. His name was Alexander Zeziba.
Wow.
What a wonderful,
wonderful.
Yeah, the cruel lie.
Yes. Well, now, I guess you want to get the photographers in, and we will make this day perfect.
Of this bill today, and it's passed by a unanimous vote of both houses of Congress, I believe is one of the most historic documents of this country, and one of the most significant. And as we think of the heritage of this nation, you know, I believe it's so important because it says to the people of this country and to the nations of the world that we still trust in the God of our fathers. And of course, you stand in a great tradition of our first president, father of our nation, George Washington, who began and ended his day every day with prayer and Bible reading. And you do leave a tremendous legacy to young people of the future. And on behalf of the National Prayer Committee and the praying people of this country, I want to thank you for your leadership and for your personal commitment to prayer. And we would say, may God continue to bless you and Mrs. Reagan and our land with the motto, in God we trust.
Well, we are one nation under God.
We appreciate you so much.
I pray quite a bit and usually begin with a thank you for all the blessings that have been bestowed.
You know, today is the National Day of Prayer, and I think probably you're the most prayed for individual in the whole world.
In the world.
And on today.
I believe in that intercessionary prayer. Mm-hmm. So
well, it's a delight and a dream come true that we've had this day. And when I spoke to you about it in October and you said you would like to do this, it was a great thrill. Now, we have tried to think of an appropriate gift for you today. And Mrs. Lee Harrington from Tulsa has produced that gift.
Mr. President, the people of Tulsa, over 1,000, transcribed this Bible special for you and Mrs. Reagan. It's dedicated to you. There are 8 beautiful volumes, and it has in the front of it where you signed the proclamation. And we just want to give you this with our love.
Handwritten.
8 volumes, real leather with gold lettering.
Genesis through Revelation.
Now, we trust that's an appropriate gift from the 100th Congress that passed this legislation and then for this year.
And it's signed. Each person that did it signed.
Yeah. That's so wonderful.
You won't see any more like it, I'm sure. It took over a year, 1 year to do it.
Thank you very much.
Literally for heaven's sake. Yeah.
And with our congressman listening in here, I'll tell you, I've still got an ambition to get prayer back in schools.
Yes,
sir. We are committed. Yes, sir. We are. We want to see that happen. Yes.
They need prayers.
Sure.
Because we know they need them.
So does every legislator in this United States, except the state of Massachusetts. Every state that
is ironic.
Begins with prayer, except Massachusetts.
Mm-hmm.
And so we need to let that be known.
So the legislators and the jurists all do it. It's just the school kids who can't, as you have pointed out many times. So maybe we just set the record.
This is just wonderful. So wonderful, yes.
Everybody in Tulsa is so thrilled about it.
I had a man write me a letter one day that sent me running to the Bible. He wrote me a letter and said that.
But you were governor and you had announced for presidency. And you walked by me and I thought, oh, what could I say? And I said, good morning, Mr. President. You left everybody and we were on television together.
Well, just know we're continuing to pray for you, sir.
Yes.
Right. We're enjoying the last act you talked about. If you'd save some good things for the last act. <you don't. laughs>
Yeah. Keep the act going.
Well, I hear over and over, you're the greatest president.
I think.
Jerry, wrap it up.
How are you?
Just fine.
Very nice to see you, sir.
It's good to see you.
Thank you. Nice to be with you.
Manuel Alvarez.
How do you do?
Thank you, sir.
Nice to see you.
Raul Isaguirre.
Hello, Mr. President. How are you? Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Mario Diaz.
Mr. President. Hello there.
Zeke
Montes.
Luis Nunez.
Hi, Mr. President.
Enrita DiMartino.
Hello.
Okay.
Representative to UNICEF.
I want to get a nice book picture here.
Over half the 600,000 jobs, the minority field were Hispanic, and
I think it's just wonderful that you, what you're doing and what you're accomplishing.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. President. We appreciate this opportunity to celebrate Cinco de Mayo. As you know, that represents a quest by Hispanics for freedom and liberty, and those are the values that you espouse, and those are the values that are very dear to our community.
That was with the French, wasn't it?
That's right.
Yes, it was. Thank you very much.
We're all fine. Have some souvenirs here for you. These are key rings with
Thank you so much.
With the seal on them.
Thank you.
Try to get here without spilling.
Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Thanks, sir.
Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. President. Thank you again. Nice meeting you again.
Thank you
very
much.
Good to see all of you again. Good to see you again.
Live well and long.
Thank you, Mr.
President. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for what you're doing.
Thank you.